Did you know that you can create a design on Canva on your phone? That's right, they have an app that's totally made for the phone. So I'm gonna test it out, show you how to use it on Canva. I haven't used it very much, so I may stumble a little bit, but we're gonna learn it together and we're gonna see how we can create something with the phone. My phone isn't that big, so it's not the Pro Max or anything, it's just the Pro. You can see it's not just a regular size phone, so I'm gonna try and use it. I'm gonna do a split screen with the phone on this side and me on this side, and we'll see how it goes. Let's see if we can actually create something with this small on the phone. I think this would be great because sometimes you may be out and about and want to create something. Maybe you're standing in line or waiting at the airport or whatever and have some time, but the only thing you have is your phone. Let's see if we can make a t-shirt design that you can download and then upload to print on demand just using your phone. All right, so I got my phone right here. I'm gonna search for the app. I have it somewhere here. I got a bunch of apps. Okay, Canva, clicking on it right there. And you can see it looks like Canva. And what I like about it is on the bottom, you can see some of the things that you need to do. Really cool, built for the phone. The UI is built for the phone. You got home, projects, plus, I'm guessing that's when you create a new design. Templates and Pro. I'm already a pro, so I already signed in. I think if you haven't signed in, that's something that you'll have to do. I remember doing that earlier. So let's just start. So that big plus right there, I like that that's a different color and it's bigger and it's kind of a call to action on that's the main thing that you're gonna do, and I think that is. Okay, so next thing, I like doing custom size. We're gonna still do the 4500 by 5400. So I'm gonna do custom size. And you can see it saved my recents because I have Canva. So I'm gonna do 45 by 5400. You may have to type that in if you don't have that preset. It goes straight to templates, which is good because I may wanna use a template and I can type in for templates. So if I wanna do something and start, maybe not start from scratch and start from a template, I think that would be great. But we're gonna make it harder on ourselves and start from scratch. So I'm gonna just go to elements first. So you can see the next thing is elements besides design. And yeah, I wanna do some kind of cat thing. So I'm just gonna type in. So let's see, maybe dog. I did cat last time. I'm gonna do dog here and hit dog. So you can see it, the searching capabilities work on Canva. That's great. Graphics, photos, videos, perfect, just like on Canva. And I'm gonna hit see all. So we're gonna do that, and it's listed by Pro and not Pro. I have Pro on here, but you can see some of these are made without Pro or don't need the Pro license to do it. So I'm just gonna do, I kind of want this white one here. Boom. So there we go, very easy. Landed on my artboard right here. Next thing I wanna do, well, we can do effects on these if we want, style and adjust and things like that, but I'm just gonna leave it at that. Oh, let's see if we need to scale it up. For scaling it up, we just grab the corner like this, one finger, and perfect. Okay, so I want it about that size, which is great. I'm gonna stop doing effects on this one, and I'll just hit that X button, and you can see again, a great down here. I can scroll through and see all the different things. This isn't a full tutorial on Canva, the app. But if you want one, let me know in the comments. We're just gonna kind of breeze through it. But if you want a full tutorial for the next one, let me know that in the comments. But we have design, which we saw, elements, which we got the graphics, text, I think I'm gonna use next. But you can see all these other things on the bottom here that we could do, which is really cool. And I think it saves some of the apps too, that like the Typecraft and everything that I usually have on Canva, which is really nice. So let's just do a really simple one. Really simple design, and I'm gonna hit elements again and maybe do a vintage sunset. Let's put that behind vintage. Whoops, I spelled that wrong. Vintage sunset. There you go. Okay, so we got a whole bunch of those. I'm kind of looking for maybe a square one. There we go, or a rectangle one. But there's a whole bunch here again, pro and not pro. There's not a lot of free vintage sunsets, at least I don't think so yet. Oh, there's that one. There's this one. Well, let's just do a free one. Why not? Okay. And you can see I can do the same thing and put this behind right there. And okay, so now we got to figure out how do we push this behind instead of in front. So maybe I'm guessing the three dots. Copy, paste, select multiple, comment, bring to front, bring forward, send to back. Yes. Boom, look at that. That turned out really well, right? Okay, so how about some text? So I'm done with that one. I'm gonna hit X here. And I'm done with that one. I'll hit X there again. Text, that's what we want. And we'll just do text. And you can see the text, just like Canva, has all this cool text stuff already. Really cool. And I like that. I love the spacing and it works great on the phone so far. I love it. Let's see, I'm gonna try out a heading. Okay, good, it added the text. I'm gonna move it down. Oh, I think I have to hit done first. All right, great. Move it down, yes, perfect. All right. Okay, first things first, let's change the font. Let's see what happens when I do that. All right, let me see if I can find a font. I kinda like this horizon. Let's do that one. Yeah, I changed it. Okay, let's see if we can change the text, just typing in it. Yeah, we can do it. I'm gonna just do something real simple like, bruh. Okay, cool. And then we can size it up. Very good, and center it. Simple, all right. I mean, not the best t-shirt design here, but you can see I added a graphic as well as graphic behind it and some fonts. But let's see, maybe I can choose the background. Yes, so let's see what this would look like on a black t-shirt. Boom, it's really cool, but the thing is my bruh is black and you can't see it. So I'm gonna click on bruh again and see if we can change the color very easily. Pick a color, boom. Bruh. Well, there you go. Very simple design on my phone and on Canva. And I could have started with a template, like I said, and then updated it, but I just wanted to see how it works by itself. The last thing we need to do is download this as a PNG, a transparent PNG, and see if we can upload it somewhere else. I'm just gonna download it just so I can save it and maybe upload it later, but just downloading it, because uploading it will test on another app and we're trying to test just Canva. So I'm guessing this top one right here is download. I'm gonna click on it. Yes, it's that one. So the one very top right is what we want, because we can hit all of these and I believe we can do download. Yes, so PNG, transparent background, which I have because I have for the pro version. If you don't have the pro version, you won't have that option and you'll have to remove the background in Photopea or some other place, but I have that. And it's 4500 by 5400. I could save download settings too, which is great. And I'm gonna hit download. And I'm guessing it's gonna give me options where I wanna download it to. I can download it and save it as an image to my photos, so I'm gonna just do that. It's saved to the camera roll, but I could also create a view link, that's fine. I'm gonna stop that. And there you go. So let's see on my camera roll if it saved it as a transparent PNG, so it shouldn't have the black background. I'm gonna go to my cameras, photos, and there it is. Cool. And if I click on it, yeah, so you see it's not black, but it's changing to that because that means it's transparent. Very cool. And I can send this PNG to anywhere or just save it. If I want to log into Redbubble, I could probably do Redbubble on the phone as well. Let me know in the comments if you want to see that. Maybe I'll take this and see what I can do on Redbubble, all on my phone, or TeePublic or whatever. Pretty fun. All right, so there you go. That was Canva on the phone and what I thought of it. I've been working in UX design for a long, long time now, over 11 years, and it looked great. Like the placement of it, the icons were perfect. You can swipe, and it did everything pretty flawless. So I think they took a lot of time. A lot of times you see these apps and they're rushed, and you know, they don't look great, but Canva really spent some time on this one, and I think it worked great. I didn't have any problems with it. I found things pretty easily, and it had everything pretty much that I saw on the desktop, which is amazing. Usually for apps, you have a subset of what's on the desktop, but the Canva app had everything. It had the graphics that I needed. I can do the search and the text and the fonts and the colors and everything. So pretty impressed. I was pretty impressed by it. Let me know what you think about it in the comments, if you really liked it or if you've used it before. This is the first time I've been using it. I've used it on the phone and I thought it did really, really well. And I'll probably pull it out if I'm, you know, wanting to design something when I have a long wait time and all I have is my phone. So I think it'd be great. If you wanna see another video about Canva, I'll put my latest Canva. In fact, I have a whole Canva playlist. So I'll put that right here if you wanted to learn more things about Canva. Thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.